All right, guys. So the game is a fun little game that we came up with where we drop a beat. You got to figure out what song it is. And then we're going to show you the video. We're going to tell you about the song. And then we're just going to have a good time, right? We're going to keep you guys entertained.
Yes, we are.
Look at that. Big shout out to Iram. Iram, glad you're on. Hope you enjoy. I don't know. You think Iram's going to get some of these songs? She'll get some of them for sure. What do you think?
I think so.
Yeah, she'll get some. So we're doing half Indian, half American. So you hear your favorite Bollywood songs that are disco. Most of them are from the 80s. And then you're going to hear American disco stuff from the 70s that is probably before most of you guys were born. But you'll still get them because you'll have heard of them before, right? So shout out to Nick. Nick from Atlanta. ATL, man.
ATL in the building. Guys.
You know what's so funny about it? Atlanta's going through the same thing that Texas is going through. So Georgia and Texas were the first two states to open up again. So hopefully the pandemic is not too tough on everybody on there, right? So
hopefully.
Hopefully we stay safe. So stay home as much as you can. But while you're home, now tell me what you're saying about the computer. What were you thinking was a good idea? So tell them. So now I was going to tell you right now about the whole idea about the laptop. What were you saying about Instagram and the laptop? Tell everybody.
So I know everyone wants to be on their phones. So if you're trying to join us live on Instagram, just use your laptop. Just go to Instagram.com and look up DJ RizEnt, DJ RIZENT. Get on from your laptop, watch it live from there so you can use your phone for other things. You get a phone call so you don't drop out of the live.
Yeah, I mean, we love you guys. You guys want to hold your phone and do it, or you have it down somewhere and you're enjoying it, fantastic, do it. But if you're looking for another option, absolutely, you can get on Instagram. You can log in, you can watch us live, and that way it'll free up your phone and free up some time and free up your hand. You get those like arm workout or whatever. Shout out to Robbie Lee from California listening in. Appreciate it. Much love. Sarah's on. Sarah's going to know every song.
Yeah, she is.
Sarah is a old soul, but an awesome person. So love you, Sarah. Thank you for being on. We're going to have a great time today. Let's get started. Nas, drop the beat. So he's going to drop this beat. Tell us what song this is right now. Guess this disco song right now.
The top songs.
It's hard to guess, right? Not everybody knows music the way we do, so we can hear a song we know right away. All right, Aisha got it. That's right. Aisha got the song. Mehek just joined. Thanks for joining, Mehek. You got to guess this song right now. Tell us what song this is that's playing. OT in the building. Appreciate it, Chicago. All right. Should we show them the video now?
We'll show them.
All right, here you go. Here's the video from this song. I'm getting a kick out of putting my hand in the video. Mm-hmm. That way I can say I was in a video.
I'm spinning the disco ball.
This graphic is so awesome, man. I love it. We spent a lot of time, effort, energy trying to get this in. Big shout out to DJ Redline from Jersey. He's the one that helped us out with the graphics. Again, shout out to Sutherland for helping with the whole setup. Got a green screen going in the background. We're just having a good time, making sure you guys are entertained and staying home. Hi to you again. So tell us about the song. What's the name of the song?
So the song is That's the Way I Like It by Casey and the Sunshine Band. To be honest, this is their second hit, number one hit that hit the Billboard Hot 100. The first one was Get Down On It by them.
That's a good song.
Man, two songs at number one. That's crazy.
They're making that money, right? That's what it is.
Yeah.
So it hit number one in America. What about the rest of the world? How did it do?
So it reached top five, like, pretty much all over the world. We got Canada, the Netherlands, Australia, Belgium, Norway, and the UK.
And Danaza and I were talking about this offline, but think about it. This is in the 70s. Mm-hmm. So the fact that not only was it popular in America, but worldwide, it got lots of love and famous and people knew it everywhere. So shout out to Kieran. Kieran, look at you on Instagram. Check out, did you see your last name?
Check out the last name.
So what happens, we love our couples. We love our past bride and grooms. Thanks for joining. Shout out to Kieran. Hope you're loving married life. I know you got extra honeymoon time sitting at home. But we're going to go ahead and drop another track. We're playing this game. It's half Indian, half American. You got to guess this song. Here we go. Guess this song right now. Guess what song this is. All right, we're going to give you 10 more seconds. Guess this song right now. We'll see if you guys know this classic Bollywood disco song. Aap Jaisa Koi, Aisha, good job. She's going to, and Sadhav got it too. Good job, Sadhav. Want to show them the video now?
Let's do it.
All right. Classic Bollywood disco videos right now. How did Mahek get this right?
She's musically inclined as
well.
That's true. She's inclined.
Does she have an old soul too? Does she know a bunch of old songs?
She probably knows more music than me.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I remember you saying that before. You think it's because of her parents?
She's all around.
Yeah? I don't see her on her own listening to this song, but who knows? Big shout out to Sarah. Sarah's going to get every single one right. So this song, tell us some information about this. So what's the name of the song?
So the song is Aap Jaisa Koi.
Uh-huh. From the movie Qurbani.
Yep.
That he can't pronounce, so I gotta say the movie names. So tell us about the song.
So the song is sung by a 15-year-old at the time, Nazia Hassan. It's crazy to have a playback singer to be that young, you know? But
yeah, and then Bindu founder, the Indian producer, but 15-year-old, that's crazy. And Sarah just made a comment. She was saying that this song, when she was a kid, she used to think it was Aap Jaisa Koi Meri Zindagi Mein Aaye To Baap Ban Jaaye, which means like if somebody like you comes into my life, they would become a father, which is super scandalous. But the song was scandalous, but not that scandalous. Very cool song. Who's it picturized on?
It's picturized on Zeenat Aman.
Yeah, Zeenat Aman's a big star from that time.
Mm-hmm.
And it was funny, there's two ladies, Zeenat Aman and Parveen Bobby, and they both look so similar, people confuse them all the time. And if you look at them like right next to each other, they look different. Like you can easily tell them apart. But for some reason, everybody would confuse who they are. So your parents definitely know this song and this movie. And we're going to go ahead and go into the next song.
Yep, let's do it.
So now I'm going to play this song for you. You're going to guess what song this is. We're doing half Indian, half American songs. Let's see if you can guess this one. This should be easy. Everybody guess this song right now. Look at that. Iram for the win. She got the song. Good job. Anybody else, if you know this? Karen got it. Good job. Now, should we show everybody the video?
Yep, it's time.
All right, guys. We're going to show you the video right now. Check it out. These classic 70s disco videos. Big shout out to Chani. Hope you enjoy, brother. All right, now, so come on, tell us about this song.
So the song is Celebration by Kool & the Gang. This was their first and only song that hit number one on the Hot Billboard 100.
That's crazy. So, and then tell them the line, the last line that got this whole song created. So the reason it got created was because of this one line.
So the song was based on the line, "Everyone around the world, come on, celebrate." It's actually from a religious book.
Right. It's a reading based on Adam. So Adam and Eve So that's the whole concept of this song. That's where it came from. So that's why they did it. And we're going to make you hear another beat. So, guys, get ready. Here's the next song. Nas is going to play a beat for you. You're going to guess the song. Guess the name of this song. Here we go.
Somebody gets this, and that means I didn't make it hard.
Nas will take you out to lunch if you guess this song.
With your credit card.
Yeah. Your credit card. He wouldn't even do that. He wouldn't even go out there. Tell everybody what's going on with Brady.
Weddings right now. We're actually weddings and funerals and what was
religious events.
Religious events.
Yep.
You're allowed 25% capacity, but I mean, I still don't feel like people want to miss out on some guests. But like, if you do, you can have an event up to 25%.
Yeah. So if your venue can hold 400 people, you can do a 100-person wedding there, and then you can have how many people per table?
Six per table.
So you can have six people per table. They want you to sit, you know, spread out. And then each table has to be 6 feet apart from the other table. So not each person, because obviously that'll be hard to do on a table. But 25% capacity, you can get it, and then you can make it happen. So if you're doing it, great. And if you're not and you want to be safe and stay home, totally fine also. But just letting you know, brand new stuff coming out right now in Texas. So that's the rules and regulations. Look, Meg's mom got it. I think she would know it. Sarah got it. Asha got it. Salaf got it. Good job, guys. You guys guessed the song. We're going to show you the video of it right now.
Scandalous video.
I didn't know that was allowed to say. Shout out to Zora for joining. Glad you're on. All right, and that was a video. Like, we were just talking about it. This is disco for Bollywood, so it's almost like a decade behind, right? So disco in America came in the
70s.
That's right, and then took about a decade in the 80s. That's when it really started showing up in Bollywood movies. But I was surprised to see that much skin in those songs, huh?
It was probably a difficult time.
It was a great time, it seemed like. It looked like a great time. So tell us, what's the name of the song?
Hurry Home, Hurry. Not Hurry Home, Hurry.
I swear it sounded like you said Hurry Home, Hurry.
Hurry Home.
Hurry Home, Hurry from Pyara Dushman. And the music's by?
The OG, Bumpy Larry, man.
The gold man, right?
Yes. Like
7,000 chains or whatever he's got. And it's sung by?
Usha.
Usha Otham, yeah. She got that real husky, deep voice. Like, mm-hmm. A lot of people think it's a man, but it's not. It's a woman. People would be surprised. There's a current two sisters, actually, that sing. They're called the Nuran Sisters. They've been in a bunch of Bollywood tracks, and people think it's a guy. Also, it's actually two girls. So, who knows?
Crazy.
Who knows? All right, guys. So now I'm just going to drop another beat for you. You're going to guess this song. And like I said earlier, we're doing half American, half Indian. Disco is the theme today. Guess this song right now. Here we go. Shout out to Ruchi. Thanks for joining, Ruchi. Asha got it again.
On fire.
I'm telling you. You guys, 10 more seconds. Guess this song right now. Or I guess you can cheat and read the comments, right?
I don't think our followers do.
No?
That.
No. I hope not. Aram got it. Good job, Aram.
All right.
Sarah got it. All right.
I think it's time to show.
Let's do it. Check out that pro, man. Your hair. Oh, big shout out to Ryan. Ryan, thanks for joining. It's funny, look at that video. You see that big old afro. So when my hair grows out, that's actually how it grows.
Try it.
Have you seen it?
I have.
Yeah. So my people don't believe it. So the reason I keep my hair so short is my hair actually doesn't grow out. It grows up. So I actually get grow. So I try to avoid that. And then that white suit. I don't know. I've had a white suit before. I just don't think I can pull it off right now.
I think it should stay in the 70s.
Yeah. Leave that back in the day. Don't bring it any closer. So tell us about that song.
So the song is Ladies Night by Kool & the Gang.
Yep.
It's their second time on our list, you know, making a second appearance with us.
Making all that money.
I know. Oh, did they pay us?
Not us, but I'm saying they made it number one,
no,
right?
No. So. Yeah, so actually it reached number 8 on the Hot Billboard 100.
Yeah.
So it's crazy that a song like this cannot get to the top 5, but I mean,
I'm sure they're doing plenty of fine with all the money they raised. Yes. Hopefully they're smart and invested and held on to that money, but who knows? All right, so guys, we're playing this game where we play a track and then you guess a song. Today's theme is disco, as you can guess, hopefully by the disco ball. If you like the graphics of the disco ball, give us a thumbs up in the comments right now. I just want to see what you guys think about the graphics. We thought we'd do something different. Normally, we have a different placement and different setup on our Instagram feed, but we wanted to do this for you guys, so hope you guys like it. Let us know. I got one thumbs up. So if you like it, give us a thumbs up in the comments right now so we know you like the graphics and you like the green screen and like our setup.
Here's the next song.
All right, now guess this song. Guess this song. Be easy one for you guys. So if you haven't figured out the pattern, we're doing Indian and American, Indian and American. This one's Indian. Sarah got it. Good job, Sarah.
Look deeper.
Oh,
the mom.
So I've got it. Look at that. Asha got it. Oh, Sarah. Oh, good job. Zara got it. Should we show him the video?
Let's show him.
So goofy.
I am a disco dancer. Zindagi mera gaana. Main kisi ka deewana. To jhumo, to nacho, aur mere saath nacho. Go! I am a disco dancer.
So Sarah said her mom got it. Yeah, but it's so funny because I was going to tell you some stuff about the song, right?
So the song is I Am a Disco Dancer from the movie Disco Dancer.
Right. And it's been remade a couple times. When was the first time it was remade?
It was remade in 2010 for Golmaal 3.
I didn't like that version.
I didn't like it either.
And then it was remade again this year, right?
Yes.
2020.
So their second attempt was just as a music video, honestly, with Tiger Shroff. And it's more upbeat, so it catches the younger people's ears, but still got to go with the original.
Yeah, the original is great, but out of the two remakes, I like Tiger Shroff's better.
Oh, yeah.
So it's so funny because I have two little kids there. My daughter's turning 10 on Friday, and my son's turning 7 in a few months. But they'll hear a song, and they'll say, oh, Daddy, is this from your time or is it from my time? Because like, there's so many remakes that it's hard to keep up with what's what, right? So there's so many things that happen. So, and who did the music of this song?
Once again, the OG, Bumpy Larry.
Bumpy Larry, yeah, that's right. And he actually sang this one, too. So he did the music and he sang it. So he made twice as much money.
That's where he bought them gold chains.
That's right. Lots and lots of gold chains. And then who was it picturized on?
Mithun
Chakravarti. We were talking about this earlier also. Like that headband thing that he's got, I don't know if it was like flipped inside out or if that was on purpose or whatever.
It's style.
But it's got like, it's like pointing. I've never seen anybody else do it, though. Like, style usually is not, you know, multiple people are doing it, not just one person.
Somebody's got to lead the fashion.
Yeah, but somebody's got to follow it too, right? I guess if you're not being followed, then there's probably an issue. So, Naji, you ready to give another track?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so he's going to drop another track for you. We're going to play this song. guess the song based on the beat, and then we're going to show you the video right afterwards. Guess this song right now, guys. Guess the song is playing. Should be easy for you guys. Sons have got it right away. Who else? Who else can get it? Irem got it. Irem's on fire, too. Good job. Asha got it. The heck got it. I don't even have to do the moves. But we'll have now to do the moves in a second. But you ready to show them the track?
Let's show them.
All right, here's the video, guys. All right, so the next time you're at a corporate event and this song comes on and we're DJing, come say hi to us. But now show them the moves. I'm going to move out of the way a little bit. Now it's coming in the middle. Show them. How do you do Y? Show them Y. Look at that. YMCA, he's got it. Look at that. He knows. He knows. Not only can you DJ, you can dance also. So catch him.
Oh, no.
Catch him soon on that. So tell him, obviously, the song is YMCA. And who is it by?
The Village People.
That's right. And then what about, did it hit the Billboard?
Yes, it did. Number 2 spot in 1979.
How is it at number 1?
I don't know.
Maybe, you know, like, there's some songs that come out and then after a while they blow up. So I wonder if maybe that's what's going on with
it. It probably blew up in the 80s then.
And tell everybody about the Guinness Book of World Records. What do they have a record for?
So they have the record for the most people to dance to a song as a performance. So 44,000 people danced to this song. At a football stadium in Texas, actually. So,
in what year?
The year was 2008.
Do you remember what it was for? It was for a bowl game, right?
A college bowl game, yeah. I think it'd be in
Sun Bowl,
something like that. El Paso.
Yeah, it was in El Paso. I think it was a Sun Bowl, if I'm not mistaken. But 44,000 people—that's like the size of an Indian wedding. Is that close?
Yeah, I think an Indian wedding beats it.
Bigger,
up.
Right? Yeah. It's you and 100,000 of your closest friends. So. But speaking about weddings, did we tell everybody? I can't remember. Did we tell everybody about the spacing and all that?
Yeah, we did.
Okay,
we
good.
Did.
Just we want to make sure you guys stay informed. Before we go on to any more songs, let's remind everybody, what's Sunday?
Sunday is Mother's Day, guys.
That's
make
right.
sure to wish your mom, spend some time with her.
Yeah.
And most importantly, we're doing a live Bollywood set this Sunday on Facebook, on our page.
That's
DJ
right.
DJ Riz Entertainment. Check it out. We start at 12 o'clock. Central time.
So first and foremost, your wife, your mom, your cousin, whoever is a mom, reach out to them. Make sure you tell them Happy Mother's Day. Hope they have a great day. Give them lots of love. Feed the ones you can that you're around. And then tell them about our Facebook event. It's 12 p.m. Central Standard Time on our Facebook page.
Yep, we'll be going live.
That way you can just have it on the background while you're having lunch or waking up or breakfast or whatever. Big shout out to my guy right there, DJ Redline from Jersey. This amazing graphic right here is all because of him. And he's constantly pushing me to get better at our live videos and stuff. So hope you guys enjoy. We're going to keep coming back and keep getting better and keep entertaining, right? We want to make sure you guys are having a good time while you're home and staying safe. Naz, you ready for the next song?
Let's do it.
All right, Naz is going to drop the next song right now. Based on the beat, tell us what song this is. Yo, Sonny, guess the song. Come on. I see you, bro. This is the year you were born. Come on. I think Sunny and Neil was
oh, really?
Amit, I know you got this one, man. Come on. What song is this? Irem got it. Irem's on fire, man. I like that.
She knows her songs.
So good. So good. Give me 10 more seconds. Guess this song before we show you the video. That you can't copy this. Shout out to Aisha for getting this song. I know she's seen this like a million times. I made her watch the video. Should we show? All right, here's a clip of this song. I joked around and said this is the only way I can dance to the bitches. That's when you know you got a cool mom. When she's sitting in a room and she hears a song and she comes out singing it, that's I was gonna say that's my type, but that's the wrong thing to say. That's a cool mom. That's a cool mom. Make sure you take care of her on Sunday. Tell us about the song. So what's the name of the song?
So the song's name is Sahara Zamana,
right?
From the movie Yarana.
Look at that! He hit the movie this time. I thought I had to write it phonetically for him, but he figured it out. Good job. Good job. He did it.
Figured it out.
Sahara Zamana, which means the whole world, from the movie Yarana, which is like
friends.
Yeah, friendship. Kinda. That's the vibe we're going for right now. And tell us about the song.
So, big actor, Amitabh's in it, his favorite.
Amitabh Bachchan, number one. I love that guy.
So, he's wearing that light-up jacket. You think that it's just in sync with the music, but it's really not. He's controlling it in his hand, in his jacket, and doing it on beat, which is crazy. Because to hit those beats that quick and dance and lip sync.
Maybe he was like a secret DJ at the time.
Maybe he was.
He could hit those beats. And you have to also think about this is a time when they shot it. They couldn't edit it. So now everything's shot in digital.
Mm-hmm.
So they can easily edit, sync it up, slow it down, speed it up. But at that time, it was shot on 70mm film, which you can't edit in that way. Like, it has to be done right then. Otherwise, it's going to be a waste. Yeah, spend all that money, get that jacket on again. They got to, like,
yeah.
I wonder how they powered those lights.
I mean,
battery. Like, he had, like, a car battery inside his jacket while he was dancing. No wonder he couldn't extend his arms. That's why he was doing this the whole time, right? It only stayed this high.
And clicking the whole time.
We're trying to make sure you guys have fun. Hope you guys do. Now I was going to drop this next track. And you're going to guess this song. So guess what song is playing right now. Guess this song right now, guys. We're down to our last couple of songs. Guess what song this is right now.
I got it too.
Should we show them the video?
Sure.
Here's the video, guys. Tell us what you think. Look at our heads are in the video. We made the video, Nas. We made the bottom of the video, but we made it.
I just need a couple more months to get the same length. Yeah.
I could do the beard. My hair. Hope you guys liked that video. Let's tell them some stuff about it. Bee Gees, oh yeah, you got it.
So the song is Staying Alive by the Bee Gees.
Right.
Hit number one for 4 weeks in 1978 on the Hot Billboard 100.
Long time ago.
Yeah.
Way before I was born. and then tell them what else. What does this song have to do with CPR?
So the song was actually used in training for medical professionals for the number of chest compressions during CPR.
Yeah. So during CPR, because it had a constant beat of 104 BPM, which is beats per minute, and so then they would use that, because prior to recent times, they did all the music live, so they played all the instruments live, so it's really easy for a drummer to be half a second off or play on beat for a little bit and then be off, because again, it's a person versus when a computer does it, it's completely different, so
yeah.
Big change on that. So that was Staying Alive. We're going to play our last song, and you're going to guess this. Sorry we got bumped off, but here it is. This is our last song for today. Tell us the name of this song. Now it's going to come up right now and play it in a second. You got to guess this song. The last song of the evening, this one's Bollywood. See if you guys can do it. Big shout out to Sarah from California. I love it, man. We got California, we got New York, we got Jersey, Chicago, of course Texas. Lots of love from all over. Guess this song right now. Chance, guys. Guess the song. Guess the name of this song right now. Southern got it. Oh, Sarah knows. Mike knows.
Sarah knows.
This is fire. I love it. I love how smart these guys are.
On the show?
Let's do it.
Shanti. Shanti Shanti Om Om Shanti Om Shanti Shanti Om.
All right, guys, that was a great movie. Tell them something that we want to say to start off with.
So the movie is Cars. The song is Om Shanti Om. Rest in peace, Rishi Kapoor.
Yeah.
Sad news.
Yeah, we lost him last week and also lost Irfan Khan, so definitely tragic. Yeah. But tell us more about this song. So who's the singer of this?
The singer is Kishore Kumar.
Okay.
And, I mean, the soundtrack of this entire movie was the trendsetter for Bollywood disco back in the day.
Yeah, but Naz and I were talking offline. Like, there's a lot of movies in Bollywood that deal with reincarnation. This is the first movie I could remember where there was reincarnation, but the person's face was different. So they didn't use the same actor to play both roles.
Mm-hmm.
I think they were just saving money when they did that. But
yeah.
Or the artist was really popular, so they wanted to do it, or they thought, you know, it would be better. Regardless, this is the first time I ever saw it where they changed the person, you know, so they physically look different from the reincarnation, which makes sense because if they look the same, they should be easy to recognize them. Well, that's a whole nother problem. So that was Om Shanti Om from the movie Curse. And then we have some information to give. So what are we doing next week? Let's tell them.
So next week we have the 90s hip-hop versus 90s Bollywood challenge.
I can't wait for that.
That's going to be a fun one.
That is going to be speed. Like, the second we drop it, people are going to be guessing that. I love 90s hip-hop. It's probably one of my favorite genres of music and time frame. You know, it's so much fun. And then who doesn't like 90s
Bollywood?
And when are we doing it?
Thursday, May 14th, 6 p.m. We know work has started back up, so that's why we moved from the afternoon to the evening, 6 p.m.
Right.
You're done with work. Just, you know.
Yeah. So this is, what week is it? Is it week five? Four?
Of the virus?
No. virus. No, of us going live and doing this. I think it's week four, right?
Yeah.
So this is the fourth week. So what we did is before we started doing this, we said, all right, we want to make sure as many people get to see this as possible. And we touch and entertain and help as many people as we can. So what we're going to do is do it on different days. So the first week we did Wednesday at 12, and then we did Thursday at 12 the following week, and then Friday at 12.
Mm-hmm.
And then now we're going to do evening. So this week we did, obviously, 6 p.m. on Wednesday. Next week we're going to do 6 p.m. on Thursday.
Yep.
And then afterwards we might pick a day, or we'll just do whatever we want.
We'll keep you guys updated.
Want to make sure you guys have a good time. Stay entertained. Stay safe at home. 90s hip-hop versus 90s Bollywood next week. And what are we doing on Sunday?
This Sunday is Mother's Day, so we're going to go live Bollywood party for all the moms out there. So, you know, if you're spending time with your mom, just have this going in the back while you're having breakfast, waking up, whatever it is.
Oh, yeah, or if your mom's in a different city or state, send them the link.
Yeah.
So it's going to, if you just go to our Facebook page, DJ Riz Entertainment, you'll find it on Facebook. Send them the link, that way they can tune in. They're going to have a great time. It's going to show that you care and you're doing something nice. And then, you know, even if you're by yourself and you're away from your mom, put it on. We're going to have some good tunes on and stay on and keep everybody entertained and have a good time throwing some Bollywood music. So you already know because you're watching, but here the handle is
DJ Riz Ent for Instagram,
right.
DJ RIZENT, and on Facebook we are DJ Riz Entertainment.
So I hope you guys enjoyed. We're gonna sign off for now. We'll see you guys next week, and send us a DM or send us an email or a message or whatever. Let us know, did you like today's show? Are you excited about next week? Or if you want to hear something else, did you like our graphics? Did you like our setup? If you want to see us do something else, let us know. Big shout out to Kamel. I'll see you guys. See you on, man. But hope you guys enjoyed. We'll be back again next week, and we'll be back actually Sunday.
Sunday, right? Yeah.
See you in a couple of days, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed.
Take care.